Ever notice the material shifting in automated machineries? Or ever notice this sound when a truck is stopping? What's common in both the cases? Yes, they both are powered by air. Using air for our applications needs a system of components working together. In this video, we are going to learn about a pneumatic system and its components. Welcome to Mr. Smart. Serving knowledge to make you smart. An atmospheric air is a mixture of several components. Water vapors. Dust particles are also one of them. Typically, an air flow will be happen from a high-pressure region to the low-pressure region. So it is clear that the pressure of the air need to be increased if we want to transport the air to our desired system. And also only a pressurized air is capable of producing a usable work. For a pneumatic system to work, it is important that the air to be pressurized and it should be treated without any contaminants. For this purpose, we have a system of components connected together called a pneumatic system. In general, a pneumatic system has a compressor, an air treatment unit, a receiver tank, a FRL unit, directional control valves, and an actuator. To pressurize the air, it need to be compressed. And compressor is a device that is used to compress the air as per our requirement. When the air is compressed, the pressure is increased at the same time the temperature will also be increased. For an efficient pneumatic system, the temperature need to be maintained and the air should flow without any dirt particles. An air treatment unit cools and filters the compressed air, producing a clean dry air, generally referred as CDA in industries. Once the CDA is produced, it need to be stored to transport as per our demand. To store the CDA, we use a component called a receiver tank. Each pneumatic circuit requires different pressure and condition of air. When the air enters the specific pneumatic circuit, it is further regulated by a unit called an FRL unit. An FRL unit is the combination of three unique components: a filter, a regulator, and a lubricator. The regularized air is now passed to the directional control valves, which are typically electronically controlled. These valves decide in which direction the air needs to be flown inside the actuator. An actuator is the place where the pneumatic energy is converted into a usable mechanical work. Typically, the actuators are air cylinders. This is how the automation system shifted the box and pneumatic system at other places works. Hope you have learned about a pneumatic system and its components. Subscribe Mr. Smart and like and comment the content. Thanks for watching.